reason. We just saw one example right there. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. Gets this to the 24 for a gain of 4.
Ronald Jones, the ball.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Brady gives this one off to Jones, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
30-yard line.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Shotgun now for Brady. And a first hookup with his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. 20, 10, touchdown, Tampa Bay. Rob Gronkowski, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Bucs have taken a first quarter lead. Charles, that was a heck of a play.
It truly was, because when he made that catch, he had to shake through some people, right? So that play, to me, a highlight film that should be accompanied by bass music, right? I mean, boom, 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 and he finds his way to the end zone. Terrific play.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Packers take over 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finish off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Josiah DeGuara. His 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Packers have drawn even here with the extra point to come.
Makes the score.
Crosby with the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And not much happening on the return, as he'll get this to about the 23.
The Bucs take over 1st and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Throwing on 1st down is Brady. Stepping up, he'll try and run. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Brady and the Bucs now with a 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line. He'll begin the drive with a give to Jones. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
The throw on 2nd down by Brady is incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. And he's got an open man. It's Gronkowski. Gronkowski. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play.
46-yard line.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. Pass the 20. And he takes it all the way down to the 3. A big run there by Jones. 43 yards on the ground.
3-yard line.
Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run it in with Jones. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the 1.
Stopped short of the goal line.
Well, he did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, trying his best to get there in this game. So far, he's been denied.
And they'll employ the jumbo set now on 2nd and 1. Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Out of the end zone.
All right, everybody in the house had to figure that was going to be a 1-yard plunge. I know I was fooled. How about you?
Absolutely. I had to readjust my eyes when it was a play fake. Good job defensively, though, to not bite.
Too bad that didn't end the series.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Ronald Jones, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs are going to retake the lead. Able to punch it in on 3rd down. Makes it easier for those guys on the sideline. They didn't have a 4th down decision to make.
Yeah, could you feel the exhale? Because they were already thinking ahead, as all the good coaching staffs do. Anticipating, will we have to make the call? They already had it lined up. Never even got to it.
And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Packers take over 1st and 10.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a 1st down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
1st down, Packers.
We are in for a good one as we're through 1 on EA Sports.
12, Packers 7.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on 1st down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
The surprise 2nd-round pick, Sean Bunting, there to get a hand in. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Now Rodgers. He'll find his tight end here, DeGuara. And this is going to lead to another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 19. 17 yards on the play there as the Packers have the 1st down as well. So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. He'll find DeGuara complete. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Give him back-to-back catches now. That one for 16. And another 1st down. Only the Titans converted more red zone opportunities into touchdowns than the Packers last year. And they've got an opportunity here, 1st and goal. And they will score. It's a Packer touchdown.
Touchdown, Green Bay.
Aaron Rodgers with his 14th touchdown of the year, 2nd of the game. And the Packers have retaken the lead.
His kick is good.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 2.
Buccaneers 12.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 23.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Brady now on first down. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
Intercepted by the Packers.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really confident throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
They try to run on first down, but this defense says no dice. They stop him a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Two.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them. They did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones.
Rodgers pass.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big game downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. You don't see this often. A quarterback of his caliber, 2 first half interceptions.
It's absolutely surprising because it happens so rarely. You're searching for what reason, what's going on out there. It's not just maybe the defense is playing well. Is his horoscope off? His biorhythms? What is it?
You went horoscope on us, David.
Well, I was thinking maybe REM sleep was off. I'm trying to come up with something.
Anything, right? 2nd and 9 now from the 21. From the gun, it's Brady. This one complete to Scott Miller. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Scotty Miller, 79 yards. And the Bucs get the quick strike touchdown. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
They're going to run for it with Jones. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. Only had a couple of yards to gain there on the 2-point conversion, and they were able to do it.
And how many teams shy away from running the football in a 2-point conversion? They treat 2 yards as if it were 20. If you're a good team running the ball, go to your strength. Go ahead and push it into the end zone.
Yeah, they did. It worked.
Bradley.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This will make it into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And 2 interceptions thrown here in this first half. You hear it, no matter the sport, they say the great athletes, they can kind of have a short-term memory, but that's easier said than done.
It is easier said than done, but I played with a guy who threw 2 interceptions in the first quarter of a really big game we were playing.
Johnny Unitas?
And no, not quite of that level and not of that age. But I remember
going for the age.
I remember looking over at him, and he was smiling. And I thought, what is he smiling about? It's because he had enough confidence in himself that was a fluke. And he went out and played pretty well the rest of the day.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Got a man open, it's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay.
Touchdown.
Devontae Adams. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Packers have drawn even here with the extra point to come. And with that, his guys take the lead here by a point.
makes the score Packers 21, Buccaneers 20.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
And Brady's throw there, incomplete.
Brady's pass.
Got out of the pocket, didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice, get rid of it, live to fight another down.
Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. He completes it to Jones. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross-state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. And he gets us down inside the 35 before going out of bounds.
33-yard line.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he gets it down to the 32. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line.
And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
He was tackled at the 27-yard line. A 6-yard pickup brings up second and 4.
From the 27, Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 16. 11 yards there, first down.
16-yard line.
Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved. The full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
On second and 15 now, Brady looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Fabian Moreau. It's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts.
It's a gain of 10.
As they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. On first down, Rodgers. And that's complete to Adams. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. To throw is Rodgers. Throw right side, going to be complete to DeGuara. The completion, but they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Devontae Adams, incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And he'll look for Adams again, and this time he's got him. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth.
A gain of seven, but it's fourth down.
No move to get the offense off the field. They're going on fourth and five. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. On fourth down, here's Green Bay's third-year punter, J.K. Scott, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. Brady going to bring the Bucs up with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Out of the gun, he'll throw. And this is caught by Evans. No gain there on the completion, second and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. That throw by Brady, incomplete.
And now offensively, it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. Open man is Godwin. It's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards.
50-yard line.
From midfield, here's Brady. Complete to Jones. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
39-yard line.
Now Brady again. Flush to his, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Rashawn Gary. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. The throw there by Brady, and intended for Gronkowski, but incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski, but now it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun now for Brady. And he's taken down inside the 30. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a third and 18.
And there's a nice catch there by Rob Gronkowski. We all know the story. Came out of retirement, got himself traded to Tampa Bay from New England in order to reconnect with his favorite quarterback. And no one has caught more Tom Brady touchdowns than Gronk, and he expects to add to that total in Tampa Bay.
2 yards the loss, second and 12.
And 12 at the Packers' 30-yard line.
And Evans hauls it in. Touchdown, Bucs. Mike Evans, his fourth touchdown on the year, as his guys are able to regain the lead. So what can Brady do here as he'll lead his guys up to go for two. From the gun, Brady, and that is caught for the 2 points. So they're able to throw it in for the 2-point conversion. Sometimes that can be a risky play, but they got it.
Yeah, you always have to be careful here, because if you do get it intercepted, it's returned by the defense, that's 2 points for them. But he identified an open target and put it right on him.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Packers take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Now this one is running back out of the backfield. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10.
And the Packer first down.
Here's Rodgers. This complete to Jones. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
Not only did we just see back-to-back nice gains, but we're also seeing the confidence rise, not just for the guy who caught it, but the guy throwing it as well.
And these back-to-back catches here out of the backfield, that can set something up downfield in a later sequence, right?
A lot of the time, it starts to draw the defense closer to the line of scrimmage. So to your point, show this swing pass, show this check down. Maybe later on, you heave one deep and you catch him close to the spot.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10. At the 47. And he'll run straight into a wall of tacklers at the line of scrimmage. It's second down. Delayed give there out of the gun. Defense was ready.
And I'm not a big fan of a draw play out of the shotgun formation, because the quarterback's not having much action where he's getting away from the line of scrimmage. He's catching the football, making a little head fake, and then handing it off. You should be able to read it, as they did there.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 29-yard line. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards.
First down, Green Bay.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. It's caught here by Adams. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Complete.
10 more there and another first down.
It's a gain of
one of the underrated aspects of Devontae Adams' game is his toughness. He had to battle his way through injury last year, and while his numbers may have dipped, he was still the number one target for the Green Bay Packers and their quarterback Aaron Rodgers, and still one of the best receivers in the league. Constantly works on his footwork,
And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Sean Murphy Bunting. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD.
That was a nice catch, and not by the guy you thought it was going to be. How about the defender turning into an offensive player as soon as the ball hits his hands? And off he goes, off to the races, and into the end zone.
Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And oh, can you believe it? He misses another one, his third so far.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he takes it all the way up to the 47. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Rodgers now on first down. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
34.
So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Rodgers again now. That's caught inside the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Escaping the pressure right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
14-yard line.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
The Packers on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 8. Here's Rodgers to throw. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that.
Brings up fourth down.
Rodgers going to go on fourth down. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown.
Touchdown.
A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers have cut it back within a score. And he's got it up and through.
Makes the score Buccaneers 34, Packers 20.
So here comes the kickoff, and what now is just a one-score, 6-point game. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 17-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Had to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 15 yards on the play, first down. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Brought down that time by Christian Kirksey.
No gain on the play. Brings up second.
Brady to throw on second down. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
That was a nice grab. Just couldn't get the feet down, right? Needed that toe tap sequence there. Whatever size shoe he's wearing, probably need about a half size smaller to complete that one.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
It's a gain of 20. First down, Green Bay.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal. Only the Titans converted more red zone opportunities into touchdowns than the Packers last year, and they've got an opportunity here, first and goal. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Packers are an extra point away from taking the lead. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this will not be fielded. It's a touchback and comes out to the 25. A few better down a score in the fourth quarter than Tom Brady. This is first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. The Pro Bowler Chris Godwin, the intended receiver. And now it's second down. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again. Brady. Space to maneuver at the 40. Targeting Godwin once more, this time complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Now Brady. And Brady, the tight end's got it. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. On second down, it's Jones. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. It's almost a tendency breaker.
Brady now on first down. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. To throw again. Brady, he sets up the screen to Jones. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Brady going to try and throw on 3rd down. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. The 4th touchdown pass of the game for Tom Brady. And the Bucs have taken the lead here in the 4th.
And that's another route that defenders would vote to take out of the game.
The wheel route?
Oh, without a doubt. You're just trying to move everybody in one direction. And whether it's a running back or another receiver, as they zip out on the sideline.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Packers take over 1st and 10.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On 1st down, Rodgers. This is brought in by Gibson. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. It's a 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. They'll come up now 2nd and 4 from the 31. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a 2nd down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Rodgers, he'll find Aguara complete. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Rodgers' throw is taken in by Jones. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. When we see another great performance like this out of Aaron Rodgers, you have to chuckle thinking that his only FBS offer was a walk-on at Illinois.
And now he's the pride of Butte Junior College, of course at Cal. And I remember watching him play at Cal, and he would run 7-on-7 drills. Angry if the ball ever hit the ground, and it didn't do it very often.
He'll look to throw, and that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. Rodgers pass. 2nd and 2.
8 yards on the pickup brings up 2nd and 2 at the 45-yard line.
To throw is Rodgers. Got an open man, it's Ratley. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
Gain of 9 yards.
Working the sideline there, good route, good catch. 1st down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
That one caught by Gibson. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 30 yards there. Only the Titans converted more red zone opportunities into touchdowns than the Packers last year. And they've got an opportunity here, 1st and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's 2nd and goal. They'll look to run with Dillon. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown.
Green Bay.
A.J. Dillon with time running out. And the Packers have moved out in front here in the 4th quarter. So now an extra point doesn't help much. They'll try to go for two to make the difference a field goal, and they can lead it by three. Back to throw, Rodgers. And no, it's incomplete. So they can't convert for two, but they still have the lead as we get toward the end of the fourth.
Buccaneers 40.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or left, now you've got a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have another play.
We'll see how they handle it.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. The give is to Jones. And he'll be taken down at the 34. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
So it all rests now on the right foot of the kicker, Matt Gay. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left. Second and 8. They'll go again to Jones.
Today's final score.
Well, Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that because when you have a lead in the fourth quarter, all you talk about doing is finishing and closing a game out. But when you flip it over, how about that? Making the comeback and then finishing the game, sealing it on defense, they will feel jubilant in their locker room.
So for Green Bay, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. Meanwhile, for the Bucs, the loss will drop them to 4-2 on the year. And they will try to get back in the swing of things next week on the road. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.
Kick it and go. Kick it and kick it and go. With a stiff arm, spin move the zones. Go, go. From sideline to touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick it off, kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go. With a stiff arm, spin move the zones. Go, go. From sideline to touchdown, I put on a show. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go. Kick it and go. I had to kick off, kick off and go.
Running it back, never a cap, out of the draft. Watch me bow, soon as I snap, hit it. Wife for the sack, shaking them out, breaking them out, talking my talk, walking my wall like I do. I sit on the throne, get in the zone, turn it on, love the shoes. Love the team, love the camp, love the crew. You need to win, who need to win, that's all we do. I've been a king and I've been about mine, never could doubt mine. They running the route, I leave them outline when I hit them.
For the bug, all black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go and water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you. If I finally starting to realize, never give up and coerce. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Tired of trying, go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? Right, I don't got time. Infrastructure, right, I don't got time. I could. It's all too, we're talking about your brother protecting themselves and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give up about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Never play by the rules, guess I'm paying my dues. They gon' try to intrude, poison the multitude. They be quick to accuse, when you got there you gon' pay the price. Best off the item, you